Thank you, Mon. Well, as Keith just mentioned, the world as we know it is forever evolving. And according to the latest census figures, Australia has changed dramatically compared with 5 years ago. There are now 25.5 million of us, and the median age is 38. There's been a significant shift in state and territory populations. So where are we moving to and how are we living? And alarmingly, despite the growing homelessness issues right across Australia, the data also revealed more than a million properties are unoccupied around the country. For more, and with all the answers, I'm joined now by social researcher Mark McCrindle. Mark, thank you for coming in. It is a really shifting landscape here in Australia. I mean, where are people moving to and what sort of changes are you seeing in the big cities?
Well, the fastest growing state or area over the last 5 years has been the ACT, really rocketed ahead. Queensland, of course, has been growing strongly as people head north. If you look at Tasmania, I mean, that's been a real standout growth area. A decade ago, there were years when Tasmania had just 500 people per year. It's been adding 10,000 people per year on average for the last 5 years. So really strong growth there.
Isn't that ACT figure quite extraordinary? What's driven that, do you think?
Growth of public service. It's also more affordable than Sydney. And it's, of course, not contained. It can continue with the urban sprawl for house and land packages. And we're seeing a lot of growth there.
Perhaps unsurprisingly, we've seen high-rise living explode. Why is that so popular?
Well, in Sydney and Melbourne, which leads the high-rise living area, you've had a lot of urban sprawl, and that continues. The fastest-growing areas being Camden out of Sydney and Melton and Wyndham out of Melbourne. So that's the house and land, that's the urban sprawl. But not everyone wants to live out there, so we're seeing a rise in the infill and the high density. 2.5 million Australians live in apartments now, so that's quite a rise. And this is the first time they've looked at 9 stories or higher. And we've got 500,000 Australians living in these high-rise apartments. Half of those are in Sydney. So that's really where the high-rise living is centred.
What about overall population figures, Mark? I mean, with COVID and the devastating impact we've seen on that and tourism here and people moving around and the borders shut, global population, or Australia's total population, I should say, isn't growing like it was.
It's definitely eased off. Firstly, we've got the lowest birth rate we've ever had. In uncertain times, we do see that birth rate drop. Wow. And secondly, we're still dealing with the repercussions of a couple of years of closed borders. So the prior 5 years, you know, when the census captured this from 2016, we saw strong growth. It's definitely eased off a little, probably at a more sustainable pace.
Yeah, and that's naturally going to have an impact on the economy too. What does the data tell us about how people are dealing with cost of living pressures?
Well, as you could imagine, with the demand for housing really outstripping that supply, we've seen both cost of housing go up and cost of living in terms of rents as well. The census records an interesting figure, mortgage and rental stress. So that's the proportion of households spending more than a third of their income, in this case on rent, and that's more than 32% of all renters.
Wow.
So, you know, if a third is going on the rent, that's a bit of a challenge, and that's a high proportion of all renters nationally.
Yeah, it's not leaving a lot more sort of money there in case of emergencies, we've seen in other studies. For the first time as well, this is really interesting, Mark, data's been collected on long-term health conditions. What did we learn there?
Fascinating data just to understand how Australians are living and what, you know, Australians are living with. 8 million, just over 8 million Australians are living with a long-term health condition. The number one long-term condition is mental health. But it's interesting how, if we look by age, it changes. So for the children, 14 and under, the number one issue is asthma. We're probably aware of that. Mm. Mental health for the young adults is by far the number one. By the time we get to the 65 plus, it's arthritis. So a bit of a tracking of the life stages there and how Australians are carrying these challenges as they move through all the other areas of life.
Yeah. It's a fascinating snapshot of the country. Mark McCrindle, thanks for being with us this morning.
Mate.